Why doesn't the sun burn out? I mean, candles run out of wax, fires run out of wood, but the sun just burns and burns and burns. Actually, burning isn't even the right word, because burning would imply that there's oxygen there, and there's not any oxygen. The secret to the sun's long-lasting energy is nuclear reactions, and you might have guessed that. Nuclear reactions release enormous amounts of energy. The amount of energy is dictated by the most famous physics equation, E equals mc squared. And that equation tells us that mass and energy can be interconverted. That's the secret behind the really high amounts of energy that the sun can put off for years and years and years. In this lesson, we're going to learn all about nuclear physics, the secret to the sun's long-lasting energy. Let's begin by reviewing our lesson objectives. First, we'll introduce key ideas in nuclear physics, and then we'll introduce the applications of nuclear physics. All right, let's jump to the key ideas. First up, the strong nuclear force holds the nucleus together. Let's think about the atom in a little more detail, and then jump back to this nuclear force thing. Okay, so here we have our atom. In the center, we have protons and neutrons. But recall that protons are positively charged. And remember that like repels like. So we'd really expect those protons in the nucleus to fly apart. What holds the protons together in the nucleus? Well, as I've suggested, the strong nuclear force does. How does that work? Here we have a close-up of the nucleus. In blue, we have neutrons, and in red, we have protons. It turns out that neutrons are attracted to other neutrons. Neutrons are attracted to protons. Meanwhile, protons are repelled from the other protons. So we have this complex balance of forces in the nucleus. But the key thing that holds it together is that neutrons are attracted to neutrons, and neutrons are attracted to protons. And so the strong nuclear force holds those nuclei together. But sometimes nuclei are unstable, and unstable nuclei fall apart. They're unstable precisely because of that proton-proton repulsion we've talked about. That leads to our next key idea in nuclear physics. Nuclei can be separated or combined. Here's a separation process. On the left, we have one nucleus, and on the right, afterwards, we have two nuclei. The atom has fallen apart. This is called nuclear fission. It's the splitting of a nucleus. We can also do the opposite. Here on the left, we have two nuclei, and they come together to form one nucleus. This is joining two nuclei together. That's called nuclear fusion, the joining of two nuclei. Okay, so the key ideas in physics. The strong nuclear force holds the nucleus together. Nuclei can be separated or combined. When they're separated, we call it fission. And when they're combined, we call it fusion. Third principle, fission and fusion release tons of energy. Fission releases energy, and fusion releases energy. How does it do that? Well, during nuclear reactions like fission and fusion, mass is converted to energy. It's done so by perhaps the most famous physics equation, E equals mc squared, developed by none other than Einstein. E stands for energy. That's the energy released in a nuclear reaction. M stands for the mass that disappears. So mass decreases during a nuclear reaction, which sounds strange, but the mass decreases and it's converted into energy. We take the mass decrease and we multiply it by the speed of light squared. Now remember, the speed of light is an enormous number, 3.00 times 10 to the 8th, or 300 million. So square that number and multiply by mass and we get the energy. That energy gets really big, really fast. Nuclear reactions release lots of energy. That really leads us right into the applications of nuclear physics, which are all about the release of large quantities of energy. The first application of nuclear physics we'll discuss is nuclear power. Here you see two cooling towers on a nuclear power plant releasing hot steam. That steam got all of its energy from nuclear reaction, specifically fission. Nuclear power uses fission. That is, for the moment at least. There are some hopes that we can develop fusion nuclear power, which might have some advantages. The next application is the sun, which I'm not sure should really be listed as an application. We didn't make the sun, but the sun nonetheless is a very important source of energy. and its energy comes from nuclear fusion. Specifically, hydrogen combines with other hydrogen in the sun to make helium, and when that happens, it releases tons of energy. The last application is nuclear weapons. That's kind of a scary application. Here we see the giant mushroom cloud from the atomic test Castle Bravo, exploded by the United States. Nuclear weapons use fusion and fission together to release tons and tons and tons of energy, a truly horrifying and staggering application. Let's test your knowledge, shall we? Determine if each claim about nuclear physics is true or false. Pause the video and give this a try. All right, let's go through each one at a time. A, the nucleus is held together by the electric force. That is false. The nucleus is held together by the strong nuclear force. The electric force is responsible for proton-proton repulsion, which really makes that nucleus want to fall apart. B, nuclei splitting is called fusion. That's also false, because nuclei splitting is called fission. Fusion is when we join together two nuclei. C, fusion occurs in the sun. That's true. We join together multiple nuclei, say two hydrogen become helium, in the sun. D, nuclear reactions release little energy. That's definitely false. As you've seen in our applications, nuclear reactions release tons of energy. And lastly, E, mass is converted to energy in nuclear reactions. That's true by our famous equation E equals mc squared. Let's review what we've learned. We introduced key ideas in nuclear physics. We saw that the nucleus is held together by the strong nuclear force, and that unstable nuclei fall apart. When they fall apart, that's called fission. And when we join two nuclei together, that's called fusion. All these reactions release tons of energy, which led right into number two, which is the applications of nuclear physics. We saw that nuclear physics can be used to make power plants, which use fission, or the sun, which uses fusion, or nuclear weapons, which use both fission and fusion. Hey, hey.